What is going on, YouTube? How are we doing today? We have the Vancouver Canucks at the Edmonton Oilers here for game four. I checked out game three. I tried to publish it. It got taken down, so I do apologize. I'm still working. I'm trying to get that up. Hopefully, I'm able to get that up at the same time this video goes up, or it might wait a little bit longer. In that game, it was pretty interesting. At the very end, it got a little bit chippy. Canucks player ended up fighting with like McDavid or something like that. I'm not too sure what really caused that. And then McDavid kind of went for like a slash, and then one of the Canucks players came up from behind him and pushed him from the back. And while that happened, as McDavid was falling, another Canucks player went for a cross check and ended up cross checking him in like the throat or the head, which is not a good look, bro. They absolutely folded McDavid. It was really aggressive. I think I saw somewhere on the news that the player from that hit McDavid from the behind only got fined like 5,000, and the player that got cross-checked to the that cross-checked him to the head got a game suspension, maybe a little bit longer. I might be wrong. Correct me on that if I am, but I kind of think that's unfair. Mainly for the guy who was cross-checking McDavid in the head. Yeah, he did cross-check him in the head. That's very dangerous and is a big no-no in the league. But I don't think he really purposely did that. It wouldn't have happened if the player from behind didn't hit him, because that's what kind of made McDavid fall and get down to that level. It was just going to be a push to the chest, and it ended up being a cross-check. So I'm not sure how I really feel about that. I wish the guy from behind maybe got fined a little bit more, and the guy who ended up cross-checking probably got a fine the same amount or even more. You guys let me know, though, about that situation. It was really weird, but let's see what this video is about.
There's Connor McDavid to start with Zach Hyman and Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. So here we go. The matchups will be more interesting tonight, at least to start. Hyman turns it back. He'll hand it off. Back it comes to Ekholm. Fakes and now shoots.
I save.
Walker stop with a rebound. Bouncing high in the slot. Another stop by. She lobs from Hyman deep in the slot. Carlson 94 along with his countryman Oman. And Bluger, that shot steered aside. Joshua kicks it back to Hronek. Down low for Connor Garland. Didn't have a shot to game three. Fired from there.
I save by Skinner.
Turned aside by Pickard. Back to the line, Hronek. And Garland again. Trying to get it through. In front to set to the line, not out. Connor Garland attacking from that. Left flank in front. And that shot blocked. And Suter takes another whack at it. Hits a leg. Garland once again centers in front.
I think Garland's being a little bit too selfish this entire power play. I wish the Canucks were passing a little bit more, spread the ice, and get a better shot selection.
McDavid swooping, didn't try the jam. Bouchard and Sheloff.
Nice save.
The blue to make that stop, but a good one. Day and Nurse together here is over the line. Comes Holloway, pass for Keane, fails to connect. And few Suter.
There we go.
Back for Vancouver. Suter with a shot.
All right.
To the side of the Edmonton
the defense.
Free feed for JT Miller. Here's Miller coming in.
Nice save.
Off the side of the net. McDavid with giddy up into the zone.
Sends Oilers with another power play. Their first power play.
Watch there by Dakota Joshua. McDavid back to Bouchard. Back to McDavid. Into the slot. Right down.
Nice pass.
Another Leon.
The dynamic duo.
Can't really draw anything up to stop this. I mentioned about not being aggressive, so they stay passive. But what the Oilers power play does better than any is that attack through the middle draws two players in the middle of the ice. What does that open up? It forces the goaltender to move to the middle of his crease, and it opens up the
damn, that like, hit him in the net.
Sprawling play there.
Still wasn't enough. That's tough.
Nugent-Hopkins turns it back. Ekholm shot. Side of the net.
I'm hitting a Mishy there. Nice save.
Nurse and CeCe together. See, Darnay and Nurse. And here comes a short-handed chance. The end mark in. Stopped by Shelob.
Just the lost battle. Four Oilers in the corner. The loose puck goes up, and now you've got an odd man rush. Quinn Hughes tries to get to the outside. Does enough.
It's a good effort. 2018-19, he played. Would have been better if he got a little bit more lift on it, but. Good attempt nonetheless.
In Philadelphia, when Knobloch was an assistant there. Bouncing in front, and Quinn Hughes up with that puck. And a hit for Garland, who had a pair of shots on the power play for Vancouver and testing Pickard.
Good save.
High there to the corner for Holloway. Keane in support comes up with the puck. Here's Keane centering it. Back it goes, Nurse firing it right on. And
huge save.
With the stop. Josh Alon thumping with McDavid as the puck stayed in the zone. And now the Oiler captain goes to work. A little touch pass by Hyman. And McDavid even Shelob with the save. Rebound found by.
That was a good build-up. I didn't like the execution, though. Right, nice on. Save.
Besser across, and it's deflected down into the Oiler zone off the stick of Suter. Good forechecking. Turns it over. Suter is found, and Becker stopped that. Henderson with Besser and Suter. Out there together right now as it comes back to the line. Go with Juleson. New shot deflected wide. Juleson in his second Stanley Cup playoff game, played game two.
Damn, Oilers just cannot clear it.
Back in his own zone. Brock Besser gets it deep. They got Bluger loose in front. Teddy Bluger.
Nice save.
Pickard stops that. Canucks off the draw. Able to work it ahead. Here's Besser. Going to the net. Besser in. Pickard the stop. Luke puck in front of the net. And Edmonton able to clear it to the line and out.
Vancouver Canucks take advantage. You got three Oilers there.
Right here. I wish he did a little drop pass to number 8. 24 then could have gotten out, get some more space, because this defender's already cutting, and it's blocking off a lot of the net, man. So I get it, though, trying to go for it, maybe get a rebound or something like that. If he was able to drop it, though, and then this guy cut out, that would have been a fire play.
And get two good chances in front. Miller unable to grab that bouncing rebound, almost underneath the arm.
Darnay ahead, back to the line, and here's a brick for Darnay.
Nice save. Another huge save.
In the neutral zone and allowed Darnell Nurse with his good speed to create a separation. But here, look at how quickly Shelob realized that puck came back to the other side. Originally, he's thinking there and then sliding across, lunging his body.
See, I like that shot attempt there, too. He went for the far, far pad so that it gets a bounce and then could potentially get that rebound to another player. If you are doing that shot, it's really about placement, man, to get the best second opportunity.
Back for Keane. Pad stopped there by Shelob. And here's McDavid trying to get loose. On after it, but it's back to the line. Bouchard shot. Rebound.
Great saves. Bro, I just love McDavid, bro. Like, no glazy shit, bro. Just right there. Dodging the hit, like, dude, he's just an insane skater.
Nurse keeps it alive for Draisaitl. From the corner, a center pass.
Nice saves.
Juleson up against McDavid, and Noah Juleson off the boards and pass Bouchard tonight. Ekholm, big hit there.
Oh my gosh. Nice shot. Nugget Hopper.
You got Myers who's caught out there. Juleson goes for
that was a huge hit.
Gets the hit, but he creates
a nice shot, great placement.
And you've got a dead tired Tyler Myers.
I just want to say it is insane to see the come up of the Oilers. Now that we're in the playoffs, I think everybody's been kind of forgetting about their regular season performance, bro. But from their start. Bro, they were being compared to the Sharks early this season. Shot attempt 47, 36, and now they're keeping a stand against the Canucks. So it's impressive.
A third period comeback, just five shots for Vancouver in the third combined.
Nice pass.
McDavid bumps it back to Bouchard. Dying seconds of the power play. They connect the full time. Rebound is a big stop. Shelob.
He just got it trapped under the skate blade, and then this is one a forehand for Zach Hyman. In
great save.
Close, gets pressured, unable to lift it up. It's good stick coming back by Joshua.
Can he continue this script with just over 13 minutes to go? We go to Joshua, trying to change the storyline. Connor Garland, three shots in the game. Sidorov, he has three as well.
Nice shot. Oh my gosh. Stop shooting.
And the Canucks are on the board.
That shot was fire.
Working the cycle down low. Joshua keeping it in position. Garland back to the point. Slides in on that block shot. What
nice pass there. I didn't even see that. And then, bro, the placement's
right the
nasty.
You got both Joshua. You got the stick of Dreisaitl.
Oh, it got.
Looked like on Darnell Nurse, but
it got kind of like deflected off of his skate or something.
Vancouver comes up with a puck. Brock Besser.
Empty net. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, it's tied. With 2 minutes left. Oh my, wow. Okay, I gotta lock in.
We've already seen one go off their own guy and in. And so Besser's getting pressured. Doesn't really have a play. And Joshua unable to get a piece of that.
Besser's steering that.
50 seconds left. Oilers.
Dreisaitl handing it off to Keane.
Good defense. They still have possession though.
Keane colliding with Hironic, getting it to Dreisaitl.
Oh! Oh my gosh! Yo, they are loving this dude, bro. Wow! What? Damn! Great shot! Great shot! 3 seconds left. Great defense. Wow. What a game. I was not expecting that from either team, bro. If I'm being completely honest, thought the Oilers might have held on just because of the penalties that the Canucks received last game. And, I mean, when does the keeper come back for the Canucks? I still don't think that's the starter keeper. Wow, this is tied series. I really thought that the Canucks were going to be taking this one home easy. Gonna sweep the Oilers. Oilers though putting in a great effort. Great game. Insane last minute goal. I think that was scored by a Holloway. Really impressive stuff by them. This is definitely going to game 6 or game 7. These second round series, man, have been really awesome. If you guys made it this far, you guys enjoy, drop a like, comment, and sub. And I'll catch you guys on the next one. Yo, peace out.